Which is this way, yeah, this one.
Yeah, we tried to take off a gravel runway. We're doing fairly well, but the speed wasn't increasing fast enough before the torque effect came in, and we crashed. And then trying to reset the plane anywhere was proving impossible because Akersin was showing our damaged landing gear. So everyone loaded up before I could reset everything and do an overhaul. We crashed over and over again. In the end, I believe I fixed it by turning off Akersin damage, reloading it several times, and then we got a plane that was serviceable. Oh, we'll try taking off again. And a faster runway. There's a gravel runway we made a mistake of taking off before. I chose it because it was directly into a 22 knot wind, so I figured that would be the best way of doing it. Except we ended up on a runway and a runway, and it was a 20 knot tailwind. And for experimental purposes, because you have to try things out, we learnt the hard way that flying into, well, with a 20 knot tailwind on a gravel runway, was a very bad idea, I must say. Set some cockpit lights on because the light is poor. There we go, my mistake here. It was just zoomed in so far that there we go. We're going to explore up here, try and find this lighthouse, come back down and land around it. Down trim kept us down longer than I wanted to, but we're good. We're up, landing gear up. I'm gonna reset the rudder trim now, so I know what I'm doing. We're heading up to find a lighthouse over here, that's the plan. That's what I wanted to do this time. Okay, let's set that there. Here is where this lighthouse is supposed to be. Again. 27 knot wind now. Headwind. It's gonna be up here somewhere. Well, it's over there, it's over to the north up here. There should be one here as well, but there should be a couple down there, but I don't know if they're actually modeled. I didn't see any light out of there. Yeah. Bank and climb at the same time because proximity of. Oh, there's a little town there. Or hamlet. Here's where the Cape Ringo light actually should be. There it is! See? So we succeeded in finding our first landmark. Here it is. Okay, let's get back to flying. Now there's a main road there. I'd be interested to hook up with that and follow it. Otherwise we're just going to have a very hazy, non-eventful sightseeing trip. That's pretty well we're landing over there, I think that's the airport. Yep, we've got a road. Here it is. I guess overall it's kind of a boring peninsula to go and explore, but I had to go to it once. Saw a lighthouse, not much else. The airport looks like it is here. That's where we're flying to. Approach your need. We do a left. Leg. Okay. 9 miles away, so it should be somewhere in this. There it is. Got it. Because we're flying a pattern, we don't need to be slowing down so seriously on this approach. We've got time to do it on that. Legs. down. It might not be mountainous or scary, but it's pretty. Give it that. Very pretty. Yeah, when you're flying in the sim without great views, it's a little hard to get the turnings perfect, because I've got to switch between views. In real life, you'd have a really good view to be able to do better night view turns. Put up flaps 3. We have a strong headwind here, so it should be going very slowly over the ground. It will seem particularly slow. So if I can avoid a bounce here. Flaps now. A bit high on that. Well, not actually. Takes some used to getting the tail drag. Getting used to the tail dragger. People waiting for us. It's always a good sign. Playing around, so that's where we park over there, but we're going to be taking off again pretty soon to quit this recording.
NZKK Kerry Kerry. NZWR we're going to.
Yeah, it'd be really cool if people actually got on a plane, but obviously they can't with this, but that'll be something else, stopping the people climb on. Oh, it's raining again. Just because you, Chris, wherever I fly in the world, it's raining. Because of you.
And that's takeoff.
November
and we'll check our trims. I know it's at the rudder trim. Here we go, let's try and make this smooth. It's flat, but it's pretty. Yeah, there's a lot of detail there, it's pretty pretty. Some over there. Oh, 4,000 feet's fine. We were doing some low flying. I might even go lower. Oh wow, that's a nice good view. Something down there. Shivering a town. What's an airport down there? Good view. But we're not landing there today. But I'm gonna take a look because they've added that, hence the shimmering. Let's take a look down. Let's do our sightseeing. Interesting, it's not shimmering in the main window. There's down there, down there. Boats. The helipad? I don't know. I'm sure what that is. Bit of haze. At 2,000 feet, we can go lower. The golf course almost down there. only 19 miles away, so we can check the airport. NZWR. Choosing the one way again. The wind is between 27 and 33, so it's strong. Be 27, so that'll be one way 32. Ooh, 1,500 feet grass. Oh dear. We don't, but we're gonna have to land the grass one way because the wind is 33 knots. We don't have a choice, so this is gonna be interesting grass landing, people. Oh, wunderbar. Okay. The first landing on grass. Interesting. 32. It's a main runway. Yeah, that the thing I want to try crosswind landing at 33 knots. That's suicide. Well, if you make an interesting landing, people not in a plane, like me. See the grass runway. I want to make sure it's there before I come into land. Good grief. Yeah, I think it's here. It's like there. There's the runway there. Good heavens. Oh, there it is. There's the... Oh, my. Okay, well, it'll be fun. Oh, lordy. You have to try it. Because life's too boring without trying things out. Okay. So, obviously, got to come in slow. With the headwind, that should be easy enough. And then... It's kind of a downwind leg. Valley. I want to approach slowly because there might be some a number of corrections need to be made, so I can view. Well, I can view outside the canopy here, up this way. That's not really helping much, is it? Again. Okay, we'll just follow the map. Gear down, I get level. Flaps 1, 2. The runway's just here. There it is. That's like one of these. Give us a brake run. Oh my god, okay. It's full flaps into the wind. for now, you start off and I think the flight's going to be fairly uneventful, but this kind of stuff comes at you. Because we can't really see, I think we're just going to be landing on grass. I mean, there's a field there, so that's probably... There's a little white stone marker, I think I saw. I'm only mildly terrified. Okay, it should be... I want to see that stone marker, but it's... Needs to be a little, almost pointer in here. Yeah, I'm landing on a field, aren't I? It's gone. I saw it in the air. We saw, oh, there, I think there it is, yeah. See it now, okay, I got it. See, you can see the brown strip. Got to be kidding me. I'm going to find out if the Mustang lands on grass. There it is. It's that thing. With water, right? Okay, for anybody watching this, if it doesn't work out... Don't hit the fence in the way. Running on grass by something. I mean, that's what it is. Okay, we're down. All we need to do now is slow down. Now we're looking to. Yeah, that's looking to apply any brakes and. Thank you, sir.
Well,
what do you think? Well, it means you could, if you land on grass, then that we could land anywhere. It's flat. That was really cool. Oh. Well, we're used to the grass. So. The thing about a sim is that you have all this. Situations. That was fun. I'm just kidding. The major advantage we had there was we had a huge headwind of 20 knots, 30 knots, which meant we were landing so slow. Once we touched down, we had a 30 knot advantage on a normal landing on a grass strip. So I think that was it. What saved. The day I didn't used to use the rudder on landing, it was really smooth because we were flying into the wind. There's nobody here, is there? Well, can I park it somewhere where we see this ground crew? Yeah, this is where the parking, the cars are, yeah. Control tower, so yeah, it's not a major OrbX airfield, it's just one of the ones put. Flaps up. That stayed there, that was good. Finishing off this session with a scenic tour from Whangarei, NZWR, westerly to Dargaville, NZDA, then south to Rewai Aerodrome, NZRW, and then heading to Welsford Airport, NZWJ. No, actually Springfield, sorry, NZSL. NZWJ is close. I'm checking out New Zealand North scenery on part one of our New Zealand tour. Okay, runway 6. crosswind is definitely interesting here. I think that's the word of authority here, finally. Gear up. Okay, so the point of this flight is going to kick out a couple of landing strips airboard. That landing there. 227. Spin. I'm going to reset the running trim in a second. Okay, first airport, Dargaville, NZDA, 25 miles away. It's going to have to fly pretty low to get beneath this haze level. And I want to see the airport close anyway. Who knows, I might want to land there in the future. Oh, it's at the... it's on a river. This will go, I guess. Maybe not. It's going to be over here, Dargaville. Low visibility. Okay. We'll be turning, we're heading 138 after this airport. In fact, we'll follow the river because the next airport, Ruwai Aerodrome, is on the river. Right, here it is on the GPS. We have our shadow. I don't think it's very realistic like that, but it's still there. So, we are flying over this aerodrome. There it is. Where the landing strip is, the grass, I guess.
Now we're heading to
a 97 degree heading back to there it is, there's our strip. Forty-five at 10 knots. So runway 34. We should have an uneventful landing. Haze is really low visibility, so we're flying low. Should make landing interesting. If I have to climb to 1,000 feet to see where the runway is, and they can't see the runway. There we have the runway. This is not going to be fun. I mean, if anybody watching. I think it's going to be a straight in, and make good laps. I'm talking so much here because it's going to be concentration required, okay? Not the ideal approach, but I have here. Poor visibility coming in. And I am very happy with that landing. Flaps up. I guess this is it. Thank you for watching this first part of the world tour of New Zealand using OrbX Active Sky 2016 and exclusively A2A aircraft. Today we were flying the P-51 Mustang civilian version. Absolute dream to fly